In this video, I'll be covering WordPress plugins. What are they? How do you get them? How do they work? And how did they even come into existence? Think you know everything there is to know about WordPress plugins? Well, stick around anyway and you just might learn something new. What is a plugin and why does it even need to exist? In short, plugins are add-ons that can be installed on your WordPress website to give it specific functions or sets of features that it originally didn't have. For example, let's say I manifest a website out of thin air using WordPress. Yeah, it's cool and all, but it doesn't allow me to create contact forms on my website straight out of the box. This is where plugins come in. I install a plugin and it adds the necessary functionality like an expansion pack. In this case, it adds the contact form functionality to my website. When you install WordPress onto your website, it can't do absolutely everything right out of the box, nor should it. Having the ability to pick and choose only the functionality that you need is essential to keeping WordPress lightweight and easy to use. But the question is, how are plugins made? In today's show, we'll be covering plugins. Everyone has plugins on their WordPress websites, but few people actually know how they're made. The first step is to extract the raw code from the Codenberry trees, then debug it using the dedicated WAMs. Once the WAMs are out of memory juice, the raw code is then fully grunged and ready to be compiled. Okay, but in all seriousness, plugins can be made by absolutely anyone who has a little bit of coding knowledge, because WordPress gives people access to certain parts of WordPress and people can write code to interact with it. The extra functionality is awesome, and using building blocks to expand your website is a hassle-free and easy way to scale up. But who the hell invests their time into making plugins and why? Well, for one very simple reason. There's money to be made. Because not every single plugin is free. You can find the premium plugins that cost from $29 to $99, and some of them have monthly pricing, some of them have one-time payments. Most plugins now implement the freemium model, where the free or light version of a plugin is completely free to use, but some features are locked. Of course, if you want to have full functionality or more advanced features, you just have to buy the pro version. A quick side note, cracked, illegal, and nulled premium plugins do exist, but believe me, it's just going to bite you in the ass at the end. Most of these cracked plugins are not updated, so they will slow your website down or break it altogether. And most of these even have malicious code written into them to make your website do things that you don't want it to do or track you or your users. But I'm not your mom. I'm not gonna tell you how to manage your website. But my professional recommendation would be to avoid them at all cost. Because you see, WordPress gets updated quite often, and plugins need to be updated together with it, so everything is compatible. Usually, you'll have to log in at least once a week and update everything, well, that needs updating. It gets quite tedious when you have more than one website, but sometimes WordPress updates are offered automatically by your web hosting provider. For example, SiteGround or Bluehost allow you to manage all updates automatically, so you wouldn't need to update every single plugin manually. And even with the new WordPress 5.5 version, you can activate automatic updates without even having a web hosting provider that offers this feature. But in general, I would recommend choosing a web hosting provider that offers automatic updates, because these usually test the plugin before updating it to see if there are any compatibility issues or does it break your website. And this new WordPress 5.5 feature, well, it just came out and there's not much testing been done on it, so I'm sure that websites are going to break. If you want to add plugins onto your website, the easiest and most popular way is to navigate to the WordPress dashboard, hover over the plugins tab and click add new. Then in the search bar, type in the plugin name you want. If you don't know the name of the plugin that you need exactly, you can just Google that, for example, how to add smooth scrolling to my WordPress website, and you'll definitely get some good recommendations there. Once you have what you need, just click install and activate. Now, the management screens vary from plugin to plugin, but in general, you'll be able to reach them through the plugin section directly or through the WordPress sidebar. And of course, I have more videos about WordPress and web hosting on my channel, because this is what my channel is about. So I recommend you subscribe if you're interested in this sort of stuff. I also leave my personal recommended web hosting companies in the description down below, and if you purchase through those links, you'll get a discount and I'll make a commission. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this video, and my name is Emmet. Good luck making your websites.